Okay, so there's two reasons why you actually are very obsessed about someone. It could be that you have an anxious attachment type and you are quite literally obsessed with your partner or your crush to the point where it is turning them off and it is causing issues in the relationship, or you are trying to get over a failed relationship. But don't despair any longer, guys, because I am here today to give you many ways to stop obsessing over that girl. So let's dive in. You need to create physical distance. You have to remove yourself from this obsession in your life by absolutely avoiding her. Stop hanging out where she hangs out. Maybe walk a different route to the office. Avoid anything in your home that reminds you of her. Now, as humans, we put an attachment onto objects. It's just one of those things we do. So you have to remove those things in your house that remind you of her and restrict the amount of obsessive thoughts that your brain creates. Now, that goes without saying. You are still going to think of her, but you have restricted how much you can physically see her to aid in your recovery. So let's be real here. If you are in a situation where you cannot create physical distance, then you need to limit your contact to something as little as possible. Let's talk about the virtual distance. You have to remove her from your social media feeds. You have to remove her as a friend. You have to unfollow and even block if you are finding it so hard to stop thinking about her. Obsession means constantly checking up on her social media feed, seeing what she liked on Twitter. So you need to make that big conscious effort to stop checking up on her. Take some time away from social media for a while because this will really help. Now, obsession can easily build into a habit. So if you are already on Facebook, it's literally only going to take you a second to tap on her name in your search bar. So add this force field and take yourself completely off the app for a while. Focus on your own attraction building. Now, I'm not telling you to run out there and start a rebound relationship. Let's get that completely out of the way. I'm telling you to look at yourself and appreciate who you are. You need to focus on your attractive features and also the things that you would like to change about yourself so that you can feel more confident. Take the time to really appreciate that you can choose to remove your focus from her and venture out into the world to find other potential ladies. Try a new hairstyle or buy a new outfit. Something that is going to make you look and feel good. And as soon as you see other women interested in you, it will switch your focus away from her and onto other people that are much better for you. Stop overlooking her flaws. We all have them, okay? It is very, very easy for us to only see a specific person in all of their glory, and we think that we are majorly missing out on their awesomeness. However, they do have flaws, and there's many, many reasons why you two were not a good fit. So it is your job to compile a list of reasons of why you don't like them, or things that you don't like about them in general, and what you would prefer in a partner. Now, add to this list the times that they did things that upset you. Now, this shouldn't be a burn book type of list. It's merely just helping you see the actual person, not just them with their qualities. Reach out to your friends. Your friends probably know the full history between you and said person, so really aid in their support. Even telling them that you're trying to get over them and that you are finding it super hard, well, they are going to want to help you and to give you some real perspective and obviously bring to your attention that girl's flaws and red flags that you never saw. So your friends will not want to see you suffering on your own, so make sure that you reach out to them when times get tough so that you don't find yourself back in that cycle of obsession. Practice some mindfulness. Oh yes, I'm telling you to tap into your prana, and yes, we're talking about meditation, yoga, energy territory right now. Obsessive thoughts, they are going to cycle around and around, and it's hard to just stop them. So instead, you have to let them happen and just accept that they are there, and that's okay. Now, mindfulness isn't new. It's been around for centuries, and take my word, it is phenomenally easy of a way to collect your thoughts and return your mind to neutral. Now, by choice, I use the apps Calm and Headspace literally daily, and I cannot recommend them enough. Focus on being yourself again. At times, we do feel that we should change our personality, our actions, habits, and behaviours so that we become more like that ideal person that we are trying to impress. We feel that they would be more interested in us and give us more time of their day if we gave them the impression that we like Lord of the Rings when really we don't, or that we are very happy to start a vegan diet when maybe we're not. This is so unhealthy because you are not being your true amazing self. So this is your homework. Just be your true self. Embrace what it is you like about you, how you like to dress, and who you even talk to. Don't feel that you have to now overcompensate to impress someone. So from a deep psychological perspective, you need to actually focus on why you are trying to change yourself. Is it because you don't feel that you are quite good enough, that you don't deserve that lady, therefore you are obsessed because you think they are much higher in value than you? You need to stop letting her opinion define who you should be. And remember that you deserve love, you deserve respect, and you deserve to be with someone even if they don't understand your hobbies. They still appreciate and respect them, and they enjoy spending time with you. So stop putting other people's opinions of yourself over your own opinion of yourself. You have to explore the actual reason for your obsession, okay? This one's very tough, but it really is a charm. It works so well. And if you were unfortunate enough not to have a caring person to call a family, a parent, caregiver, whatever it may be, and you are very likely to repeat the same cycles that happened as you were a kid in an attempt to fix them. However, any attachment therapist is going to tell you that you cannot fix any attachment wounds by repeating them. So you might think, I can heal how my dad treated me by just letting her get away with stuff. It's not going to work. Instead, you need to fully understand your own behavior in the relationship, and you have to figure out why you are holding on to someone that is not giving you the same feelings back. Find a therapist. With all of this stigma out there about finding a therapist, we kind of feel slightly awkward to even admit to ourselves that we need to embrace more coping skills. And I want you to know from heart to heart that I don't care what your friends and your family would think about you. If you need to gain some skills that you were never taught before, going to therapy is amazing. See it as a supermarket. You don't have something, you buy something to have it. It's an amazing decision to do. And it gives you such a grown way of taking control of your life. And of course, you're going to be filling in those gaps that your brain hasn't quite understood. Now, finding a therapist will really help you to understand the reason for your obsession, which ties into the previous tip. Now, if you do have an attachment trauma, specifically the anxious attachment, talking to a therapist is going to help you to unravel those traits that you have so that you can finally let go of that person. And sometimes just talking to a therapist that you have trust in, knowing that they are not going to judge you and they will give you professional advice, is something that will help you to break this cycle of obsession over that girl. I am fresh out of tips, but if you do want some more, then don't worry. There are some videos here next to my head. Go click on these because I really think you will like them. All you have to do now is tell me how much you enjoyed the video, give me a huge thumbs up, and subscribe to the channel. Stay safe, stay happy. Bye-bye.